I'm happy to be here with Dr. Charles Lim. Thank you so much for joining us, Doctor. And I want to talk to you about something I'm personally very interested in, the ability for CI users to have a positive music experience. Can you talk a bit about that?
Sure. So, you know, music, I think, is maybe the most challenging form of sound for a cochlear implant user, mostly because it's really difficult. These implants are designed primarily for speech, which is a fantastic, phenomenal thing. It's a great achievement. But I think that music is sort of another level. And so I think that an implant user has to have kind of a nuanced approach to music. They have to understand that it might not be exactly the same thing that they might have remembered or the same thing that somebody with normal hearing is experiencing. But I think that certainly a source of joy for a great number of implant users.
This is a bit of a curveball question, but have you had musicians get a CI, go through that process? What is the experience coming out the other side?
Yeah, so I think like the person who seriously loves music and the person who's very trained in music has a very different approach to sound in general. Mm-hmm. And I think that their ability to articulate what they're hearing is better, their ability to criticize what they're hearing is better. And usually the people that perform the best with cochlear implants do have some musical background because they're just very good at processing sound. But it's always an interesting experience for the musicians that get cochlear implants, always. Yeah.
How have advancements in coding and computer programming in other areas played a role in music and CI?
So I think there's a convergence that's happening where people that are interested in music, people that are interested in the audio industry, and then people that are interested in hearing loss are starting to look towards one another and say, well, how can we benefit from the knowledge that we're all accumulating? Mm-hmm. So far, it's been a little bit siloed. And so now we're starting to look, for example, at the music industry and the audio industry and say, well, you know what? They make things sound good in the world for people that have normal hearing. So how can we take some of that information and sort of extrapolate it to the hearing impaired world? But there's a lot of room left to improve on this. We have a lot of ways, a long way to go to make things perfect.
Can a CI user practice with music? Is it something that can be a personal journey that can be improved on?
1,000%. You know, I think that one of the kind of tragedies is that we tend to relatively ignore the importance of musical training for somebody who has a cochlear implant. You know, when somebody's deaf, they're not really given access to or really even encouraged to have music lessons. It just sort of seems like almost unnecessary. But it turns out that if you take somebody with a cochlear implant and you give them musical training, you're really sort of forcing them to confront their limits of their implant and also to understand how to think about what they're hearing in a very kind of cognitively objective yet also subjectively moving way. And so I think there's a lot of reasons to try to teach somebody who has a cochlear implant music.
What specific tips can you give them?
It's hard. And so I think that the first thing to realize is that, you know, for people that have normal hearing, listening to music is not difficult. For people that have a cochlear implant, hearing music is challenging. So that's an immediate disconnect. There's this idea that the world is in tune. For example, when you play a piano and you have normal hearing, you expect it to sound right. It's not really the case. You can't assume that for a cochlear implant user. So I would suggest that a CI user not use an instrument that they have to intonate by ear. For example, something like a violin is quite a bit harder than something like a piano where you just actually have to press the right key. Mm. And what you're hopefully going to do is train your brain to hear those keys rather than rely on your hearing to produce the right note.
That is so, so interesting. As a piano player, I love hearing this because you can learn music on different levels.
Yes.
And different skills, you know, go into learning an instrument.
Absolutely. I have some deaf patients that actually play piano surprisingly well and better than they hear, in a sense, because
right.
They're really almost approaching it like a computer keyboard. They're typing mm-hmm. almost on the piano, and they're doing it very well, and so it sounds great. Their ability to hear what they're playing is not as good as what they are actually playing.
If you were to quickly sum up, you know, what you see as the future of music and CI, what is it?
I think that we need music-specific processing strategies and maybe even music-specific hardware, even at the electrode level, to try to really target the idea of getting accurate pitch perception. That, to me, if we could get that across, that would probably be the most important accomplishment for music and cochlear implants.
Thank you so much for talking to us today, Dr. Charles Lim. Enjoy the rest of the conference.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.